Gorgeous Moment Talk Show, another exciting episode in the Women Empowerment Series. We would like to start by wishing you once again a happy International Women Month. You know, this month is a month for us to look at diverse, you know, talents, wisdom, and everything that women has been blessed with. So today we have this amazing woman of God by name Pastor Mrs. Ruth. By the way, she and the husband run this wonderful ministry referred to as an Exalted Christ Church International. Glory to God. It's in Durban, South Africa. Amen. So she's here to talk about a topic we refer to as the dynamic woman. I was inspired for her to take this topic because I started following her online, glory to God, during this pandemic period, and I noticed she emphasizes a lot on the dynamic woman. Amen. I said, no, this woman of God will have something to give you guys. So stay tuned, grab what you got, and let's listen to what Pastor Mrs. Ruth has to say about being a dynamic woman.
Amen.
Pastor Mrs. Ruth, you're welcome to Mom and Just Talk Show.
Thank you so much for having me.
Please introduce yourself. You're welcome.
All right. Hi, everyone. I would like to thank you for giving me this opportunity.
We give God the glory.
Amen. My name is Pastor Ruth Mucha. I'm the wife to Apostle Michael Mucha, who is the founder of Exalted Christ Church International. Amen. And I'm the one that is the runner with our interdenominational ministry for women called Dynamic Ladies. Amen.
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 So let's delve into the topic. The topic for today is the dynamic woman. Who is a dynamic woman?
All right, so I'll give a definition of what a dynamic woman is. So firstly, for our ministry, we look at a dynamic woman as a woman that is faith-filled, a woman that is standing strong on the faith within the Word of God, and she's a woman that is not moved nor shaken by circumstances. So that is the essence of a dynamic woman. Yes, there are other virtues that do come with the woman being a woman of faith, that is being a prayerful woman, a woman that is like a dynamite ready to explode and influence and bring change within the community that they are coming from. So that is the dynamic woman. You are not a weakling, no, but you're realizing the potential that God has invested
Absolutely.
In you, and you are starting to run with
Amazing.
That potential that is
Amazing.
In you.
Awesome, Pastor Mrs. Ruth. I love that take. Let's know what the Bible has to say with reference to the Word of God. What is a dynamic woman all about?
All right. So for me, when we look at the Word of God, there are so many examples in terms of women that have started within the Bible that have shown us what it is to be a dynamic woman. So for the first point of call for me is for me to look at the lady that is Rahab. When we read in the Word of God, we see Rahab. She was a woman who realized that in Israel there was a God who was great. And then she said, but from where I'm coming from, there is no greatness as such as I see in Israel. So what did she do? She decided that this God, if I embrace him, he is going to change my past and he's going to put me in a different position.
Wow.
So when Rahab realized that the spies from Israel had come into the land, she did not go about in fear, but she said, let me tap into that anointing that they have. And she invited them, and they came in into to her home, and she hid them, and she lied and said, no, they went that way. She preserved the spies that had come into them. And from there, as a dynamic woman, she realized, I can no longer be a harlot, as people call me. I need to be translated into something
Absolutely.
That is greater. And
Absolutely.
What do we see when we look in the Word of God? We see Rahab is mentioned even in the Hall of Faith when
what?
We read the Word
wow.
of God.
Wow.
And she's
wow.
in the genealogy. Why?
Awesome.
Meaning that she took a stand and she said, my past cannot define me, but what this God can do is what I will run with. So a dynamic woman is that woman who is able to see that, okay, circumstances, yes, they might be against me, but if this God is the God who is the true Almighty and I run with him, he's able to change my circumstances. So that is the dynamic woman we see in the Word, who is not moved by what has happened to her. Yes, no condemnation, because the grace of God was there for Rahab, and it moved her from where she was.
Transformation.
So that is when we look in the Word of God. So even today, maybe there is a woman that is listening to this session. You think your past circumstances might deter you from being the dynamic woman that the Word of God is saying you are. No, don't look at the past. Surrender your all to God, and he will take you from now forth, and you become the dynamic woman that he
wow.
set for you
wow.
to be.
Thank you, Pastor Mrs.
Amen.
I'm blown away by this. Viewers, I'm sure you are too. You know, this is very interesting because I had just done your intro before coming to this. Glory to God.
Amen.
I have just said the same thing in my intro.
Hallelujah.
That a dynamic woman starts with transformation. Your past should not hinder you from becoming who God has made you to be.
Amen.
I mentioned also that a dynamic woman is someone that lets go of whatever has happened in the past. Just as you mentioned the story of Rahab, she let go of whatever had happened in her past and she was ready to move to the future. Viewers, if you are watching as a woman, don't let your past determine who you are tomorrow. Don't let your reality for tomorrow be tarnished by your yesterday. Don't be haunted by your yesterday's past. That is my take home, and I do believe that you have been blessed by that as well.
Amen.
Pastor Mrs. Ruth, let's get to know, what are those virtues that are expected of a dynamic woman?
All right, so for me, one of the most important virtues is for you to be a praying woman. Every dynamic woman, you cannot be making a popcorn prayer that is a 2-second microwave prayer. No, you should be able to groan in the spirit, and most importantly, pray in the Holy Spirit. And when you do that, you begin to grow and grow. One of our favorite verses at Exalted is Jude 20, where we say you pray in the Holy Ghost and you begin to grow in your most holy faith and you rise up like an edifice. So a woman who is a dynamic woman, there is no shortcut. Prayer has to be your second name. Like what we read in the Word of God, when we read especially in the Message Bible, it is a scripture that says make your life a prayer. So a dynamic woman, your life has to be a prayer. Whatever you do, you don't start with gossip, but you start with prayer. That is the most important virtue. And when we read the Word, we see the prophetess Anna. What does the Word say? She says the husband passed away when she was very young, but for over 70 something of a lifetime she was in the temple praying day and night and fasting so that Jesus Christ will be revealed. That is the most important virtue for every dynamic woman. You need to be a praying woman. You need to be, the first point of thing you do is praying. Whatever you need to have, not emailing your friends or Facebooking, but you should be having knee mailing. That is, you are on your knees every time and you are praying as a dynamic woman. That is one of the most important virtues.
Thank you so much. In fact, being a prayerful woman covers for every virtue because it's a cement. Prayer is a cement that builds who you want to be. If you take everything to God, you get a direction, a sense of direction for your purpose, for your destiny, for everything. So I thank you so much for that wonderful takeaway. Let's know, what are those hindrances that, you know, stop, sadly to say, I was going through a study and it says the graveyard is known as the wealthiest path. It has the wealthiest because so many have gone to the grave with their wealth of talents and potentials. What are those hindrances that are stopping women out there from being dynamic, from you know, fulfilling or manifesting that purpose that God has willed for them?
It's so true what you are saying. You see, I remember one sermon that Miles Monroe used to preach. He always would say that the graveyard is filled with such diamonds and gold of information where people never realized that they actually had this potential. And one of the most hindrances that people have, like for women, it's they themselves. Sometimes we start to look for the devil here and there, but it's not the devil. It's actually I as an individual who is a hindrance for me to becoming the dynamic woman that God has set for me. When we read the Word of God, we look at Sarah, the mother of nations. What did she do? She was almost on the verge of becoming a hindrance to the purpose that God had set for you, because God said to Abraham, you are going to be the father of many nations, and he even changed the name of Sarah and also made it to be the mother of nations. So what then do we see? We see when the three men came to Abraham, he gave an offering, he prepared food, and they released a prophetic word which Sarah was hearing herself, that by this time next year you are going to be having a child and a son of the promise. And what did Sarah do? She laughed. That is what the Word of God says. She was laughing to saying, ha, me, with all these years that I've been barren, and these people should be like, do they really know me? She became the hindrance herself. Even when we look at the word that God had given to Abraham, she then proposed, Abraham, please take my servant so that maybe I can have a son. She herself became the hindrance to what God had spoken. So sometimes we look in the physical and we do not focus in the spiritual to say, God, we are constantly connecting to what you have spoken to us, even if it's taking long, but we will keep on holding it. And then we take shortcuts, which then divert us from becoming the dynamic woman that we ought to be. So as a dynamic woman, begin to work on yourself to say, God, let me not be a hindrance to the promise that you have said to me. Let me not be a hindrance to the package that you have instilled in me. That I lay myself here, I decree, God, have your way, so that that which God has said for you then begins to manifest. And you say, God, I'm laying aside. Because if you don't deal with yourself, other things, yes, might come, but you still become a hindrance to yourself. So many things, even excuses, etc. Sarah was giving Abraham an excuse as a hindrance, saying, but now I'm old, maybe if you take this one. Excuses becomes a hindrance. Gideon even gave excuses to say, I'm now the least of the family. This is that. An excuse also becomes a hindrance, but it comes from you as an individual. So you need to say, God, I am working on me. I know your word says it, and it's not by power or by might of my own, but it's by your spirit and by the strength of God. So I am laying myself, I'm letting it go, and you have your way, so that God can begin to work out with you and you begin to live that purpose that God has set for you. So don't hinder yourself. That is one of the most important things.
I pray that we will not be hindrances to ourselves and to our potentials in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I forgot to ask this very important question. Why is it important for every woman to be dynamic in nature?
It is important for every woman to be dynamic because you now begin to walk in the promise and the destiny that God has set for you. So whether it be socially, in your community, when you become dynamic, you begin to fulfill that. When we read the word, we see Tabitha, what happened to her? She began to fulfill the dynamic woman in her, which impacted her community, such that when she died, people were crying that no, they did not go to say come and heal her because of ABCD, but because they said, if she dies, who is going to give us the clothing and this material? So within her social surrounding, she realized the potential of her being a dynamic woman, and it impacted the community. So even those people who were not knowing God, they began to know God because of the works that she was doing as a dynamic woman. So you have to be a dynamic woman, because socially you become empowered. Even spiritually you become empowered. You become a faith giant. You know that nothing will come your way. You know that no gate of the enemy will prevail in your life, because you are standing strong. You are spiritual stamina. Any giant, you know that in the name of Jesus you command it and it will be slain, because you are now beginning to function. Nothing just happens like just we will see how it happens. No, you will have the ability to control it, because you are working in that purpose.
Thank you so much, Pastor Mrs. Thank you so much. The importance can never be underestimated. You make an impact in your society, in your family, in your nation, and globally.
Amen.
It pays to be a dynamic woman. I pray the Lord reveal whatever potential He needs to put in you, He has put in you, to manifest and be impacted in your world, in the world, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Pastor Mrs., please, can you give them a take home steps on becoming a dynamic woman and advices on how they can become a dynamic woman?
My advice to you is the most important thing from prayer, also, as I mentioned before, is that you read the word of God. Have a relationship with the word of God. Don't have it only that when the pastor says it on Sunday, that's when you're like, okay, this is the word. No, have a relationship on your own. Take time to read the word of God, because nowadays, in the times that we are living in, dynamic women always have an excuse. I am busy. Oh, my child, this and that. Procrastination. Oh, I need to cook. Oh, I need to look for my... Yes, you may have all those things, but never neglect your spiritual life. Read the word of God. Have a revelation with the Holy Spirit. Have a relationship with Him, because as you do that, you will begin to grow as a dynamic woman. And what does the word say? Is that the Holy Spirit will reveal truth unto you. So you need Him. When you have that relationship with the word, then the Holy Spirit begins to speak to you. And what will happen? Doors will be open for you, because He will direct your path in your business. He will direct your path over your children.
Absolutely.
The Holy Spirit will direct your path. Wherever, where you are married, the Holy Spirit will direct your path. At your work place, you will be elevated, because it's the Holy Spirit that will guide you. You will not say, I took a wrong step, because if you wake up in the morning, then the word will tell you, do A, B, C, D. You will begin to manifest and confess that word, and then you walk with that word. But most times, what do? We wake up, I'm on Facebook, and I'm laughing, see this tweet, and whatever. And what is directing you is the Facebook tweet and not the word of God. So you need need to have the word of God to be the direction, that it may be the lamp unto your feet and the light unto your path as a dynamic woman. So that is my take home for you. Don't neglect reading the word every day. Try a verse a day if you can't do a scripture. Eventually you will build your stamina and you will begin to read a chapter up until you grow up and you are spiritually and strong within the word of God. Yes, and you are rooted on the firm foundation, which is Jesus Christ, because he himself is the chief cornerstone, and in the beginning was the word, and he is the word. So you need to have that word. You need to have the word of God in you.
When you ask so the word, I've been blown away. In fact, I'm goose pimples right now, guys. Viewers, if you're watching, I think we need to play this and reflect on it again. My take home from this: be a praying woman and make the word of God your beginning, your day with the word of God.
Amen.
And I would like to add, make the Holy Spirit your friend.
Amen.
Have a genuine relationship with the Holy Spirit. This can only happen through the word of God. Because sometimes you open the word of God, the Bible, and you're not sure what to read. But if you have that Holy Spirit as your best friend, speaking to you every now and again, sometimes the word drops. Go to this scripture. Go to this. And you will see that that is the scripture you needed for that
day.
Definitely. So if you have that relationship with the Holy Spirit and your soul has been saved, I tell you, everything flows. Thank you, Pastor Mrs. I've been blown away, and I'm sure the viewers have been. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to this channel for subsequent episodes. And just in case you want to follow Pastor Mrs. Ruth, she and her husband, they own an amazing ministry and they are doing well on Facebook. You just watch out for Exalted Christ Church International Overcomers. They're on Facebook, Instagram as well, right?
Yeah, we are.
And YouTube.
And YouTube, yes.
God bless you and see you soon. Bye.
Bye.